Hi, good evening to all of you. This is Parmesh from Care Industrial Automation Services Private Limited. Today, we are going to discuss about a small demo on industrial automation technology. What we are going to use in industrial automation, what type of tools we are going to use, and what healthcare training is here. Everything I can explain here. Coming to the industrial automation topic, here, automation. Here, in the automation is a Greek word, actually it is. Auto means self, machine means control. Okay, self-control. What we are going to use here? We are going to control the industry in self-controlling process. Okay, automatically it should run. That is our major intention of the industrial automation. Okay, but industry, in every application, we are not going to use an industrial automation. Particularly some applications only we are going to use our industrial automation technology. Okay, where we are going to use is input. Let us say, for example, every industry is having different type of applications, different type of machineries. Okay, every industry is having different applications. In applications like the cutting machine or filling machine, okay, packing machine, otherwise printing machine, filling, packing, moving, conveyor, mixing applications, and pick and place machineries. So many will come under the applications. Okay, and each and every application is having an SOP. Okay, SOP is the standard operating procedure. Each and every industry is having application. Each and every application is having SOP. What is our work is nothing but here. We need to satisfy an SOP of an application. Okay, we need to satisfy an SOP of an industry, an SOP of an particular applications. Okay. For controlling this SOP, to satisfy this SOP, first preference is here a PLC. Okay. PLC is nothing but programmable logic controller. In the name itself, it is having programming. That means we need to write a program. Okay, and then we need to create a logic, implement a logic with special functions like timers, counters, comparators, same functions like that. And we need to control a particular application. Okay. What is our PLC is doing is nothing but it is going to satisfy an SOP of an industry. Some industries is going to maintain SOP as a drawings, as a program, as a programming backup. And some of people are using with algorithms also, step-by-step processors like that. Okay, what is our PLC is going to do here nothing but it is going to satisfy an SOP. Okay, I will go with one small application, small conveyor application. Based on that, what is PLC is going to do? Everything you can create on that. Let us say, for example, one conveyor is there now. And the application here is a filling machine, a small filling machine. It is one conveyor. And to run this conveyor, here I'm going to use the motor here. I'm going to use a motor here. Motor shaft gear system is connecting with the conveyor. Okay. And here I have a bottle seal here. Okay. When I press the on button, here on button, off button is there. When I press on button, first conveyor will run. When conveyor is running, then automatically bottles will move. When it reaches to certain set point, this is my set point. Okay, this is my set point. When it reaches to this set point, automatically first conveyor should stop. Conveyor will slowly stop. Next, here we have a tank will be there. Tank is having one solenoid valve will be there. Okay, when it reaches to certain set point, solenoid valve will open. When this valve is open, then filling is going to run. After completion of filling, again conveyor will stop. After completion of filling, then again conveyor will stop. Then one more bottle will come to the set point. Then again filling process will go on. Like that, it is going to a repeat condition. What is mean by an SOP here is nothing but step-by-step procedure we can write here. Let us say, for example, first push button on. When push button on, then conveyor is running. In conveyor is running, conveyor is nothing but a motor running. Okay, it reaches to set point. For getting this set point, I am going to use here a sensor here. Sensor will detect the object. Next, solenoid valve will run. In solenoid valve will run after completion of filling process. I am going to take a timing of here 5 seconds. After completion of 5 seconds, solenoid valve will on. Then conveyor will run again. Then sensor objects. This procedure we are going to call it as the SOP. Then what PLC is going to do here is nothing but, let us say for example, first point in push button on. Push button is input to the PLC. Push button is input to the PLC. Okay. We need to write a program. Let us say for example, PLC is complete a hardware device. It is a hardware device. Okay. We are going to write a program of these are all SOP in one personal computer related with this PLC. Each and every PLC is having a special software over there. We need to implement this program in an related softwares. Okay. And we need to dump into the PLC again. We need to dump into the PLC. Now, this PLC is having these are all processes. Okay. Whatever the push button, first procedure is push button on. Push button is input to the PLC. When push button is on, then first conveyor should run. Conveyor is output of a PLC. That means motor is output of a PLC. Then again, when it reaches to set point, then means sensor on. Sensor is input of a PLC. When set point sensor is going to run, then first of all, motor will off. When motor is off, then automatically solenoid valve will run. After completion of 5 seconds, then again, it will go into stop. Then again, conveyor will run. Then reaches to set point. Then again, solenoid valve. These are all input to the PLCs. These are all output of a PLC. Where these are all PLC inputs and PLC outputs are there is nothing but it is in the field only. These are all the field like conveyor application is there. Conveyor is I'm going to assume it as a field. In general consideration also, we are going to consider it as a field. We have to take the inputs from the field. First, what PLC is doing here is, but we'll take inputs from the field and scan a program according to the SOP of a particular application. Okay, and it will generate the output. And the output is where it is in the same field only. We'll take the inputs from the field, scanning a program, it will get the output. And the, whatever the output will be there, the output is going to control the same field only. Okay, whatever the push button sensors, everything we need to give by wiring to the PLCs. What you are going to learn in our training session is nothing but you are going to learn about what type of PLC input wiring will be there, output wiring will be there. Okay, how we need to write a program here, and we need to dump into the PLC like communication, and we need to implement these different type of special functions like timers, counters, programming interlocks. How we are going to give everything. Okay, we have hands-on experience to the students also. So in every PLC wiring, student should do the wiring. Okay, there are some conditions over there. Okay, next, second module is HMI. Second module is HMI. HMI is a human-machine interface. Human, okay, human-machine interface. In the name itself, it is having a human machine interface. It is interface between a human and then a machine. Okay, a man is going to control the machines and he can monitor also. Like both directions should run. No? That's the reason we are going to call it as an interface interface. Between this human and machine, we have a mediator in there. That is our HMI. Okay, HMI is having the same thing. It is also same hardware device. We need to write a screens designing. Okay, each and everything we need to implement in a personal computer related with the software, and we need to dump into the HMI again. Here, in front of you need to implement a program in HMI. Okay, Before going to that, I will take a small example how it is going to running everything. Okay, here in machine I have one motor will be there, a small motor. Motor is there, and I need to run a motor through this touchscreen device. It is a touchscreen device, Martin. Actually, it is touchscreen, or some people are using keypad also based on applications. Okay. In the next. First, in our task is we need to run a motor. We need to run the motor, and for running the motor, I need one on button, I need one off button, I need one on indication, off indication, on indication, then off indication. We need to get the feedback also. No? That's in that point of view, I'm going to take a indication purpose. I'm going to take here a lights here. Okay. First, we need to enable this button. When you press this button, signal will come to first of all PLC. Signal will come to first of all PLC. From PLC to will go to the motor. Okay. From PLC to motor, it is having a direct connection will be there. Okay, but each and every signal of HMI will go to first of all the PLC here. Whatever the PLC it is, depends upon the application. Okay, depends upon the brand of an HMI, depends upon the communication. Okay, let us say for example, motor is in off condition. That feedback will come to first of all PLC, from PLC to HMI, like that. PLC and HMI both are interlinked points. Let us say literally, we are going to take an HMI only for the PLC only. And every human is expecting a smart work over there. We need to give a screen over there. When that person's, they have to operate a particular motor, they have to use a screen over there. For that purpose, we're going to use an HMI here. But from HMI to motor, there will be an mediator device will be there, that is PLC. If any problem will occur in PLC, then automatically HMI will also not work more there. Related, well, because these are interlinked program. HMI doesn't have any input wiring, any output wiring. It's having only the software, and behind of that one cable will be there. COM port will be there. Through the COM port, we need to give wire to the PLC. Then automatically we need to down. You need to write a program in PLC related to HMI. You need to write a HMI program related to PLC. Okay. What you are going to learn in our institute is nothing but we need to, first of all, we need to design a HMI, how we need to design an HMI screens over there. This is a topic will be there, like unlock, scaling, and then next timing representation, digital unlock, trains, alarms, digital alarms, unlock alarms. Everything will be there. We need to how you are going to implement the screens, are you are going to learn here. Okay, and we are going to teach with the communication of PLC how the motor is going to run. Okay, it's all will be a practical section. We need to learn a practical session in our training institute. Okay, hope you understood. Next point. SCADA. Okay, SCADA is nothing but everyone will going to see regularly in your working area, and some students who are till in the graduation also, they are going to learn this. These are all SCADA, a basic level only, even the diploma and BTEC students also. But in the name itself, it is nothing but supervisory, control, and data acquisition. Okay, it is a supervisory, control, and data acquisition. Okay. Before going to this, first of all, up to now, what we learn here, we learn, let us say, for example, total plant will be there. Every plant, I'm going to treat it as one steel plant example. Each and every plant is having different section, no? Section 1, section 2. In section 1, I'm going to use an SOP here. Here also seeing one more SOP. Okay. And the next, we have different opportunities. This is one cutting machine 1 now. This is cutting machine 2 will be there. For controlling of these all cutting machine 1, 2, 3, and so on, 18 or 20 machine also, we can use one PLC. You can use one PLC. And HMI way we are going to use is nothing but we are going to use a particular application in particular cutting machine area only. This is an HMI area. This is an HMI area for operating particular application. HMI is having a limited screens. There is no unlimited screens will be there inside of the HMI. It is having a limited memory compared with the SCADA over there. Okay. And we are going to use an SOP with the PLC here. And this area, I'm going to consider it as a local area. I'm going to consider it as a local area. Some people, they are going to call it as a working area or also workstation, different names. Every industry is having a control room with their control room. Some people are going to call it as an operator station. I'm going to treat it as a remote area. In remote area, I have a personal computer. In personal computer, I need to monitor off entire plant elements. I need to monitor cutting machine one on how many motors are there, whether it is running or not, if it is running, which condition it is running, whether it is a good condition or error conditions like that. And let us say, for example, any tank process will be there, like whether the temperature is running or not, if it is running, how much temperature the tank is going to run, whether tank is going to filling, in which level the tank is there. Okay, and everything we can monitor here. Okay, and we can control also. This is monitor point. This is control. And we can monitor and control of an entire plant. Where it is coming, how it is coming, is nothing but each and everything signal will come to the each and every signal will come to the first of all PLC. Each and every signal coming from PLC also. Let us say, for example, if you need to monitor a cutting machine is running or not, this feedback will go to the PLC. PLC is going to interlink with the SCADA. And this personal computer, we're going to call it as a SCADA. How we are going to monitor is nothing but through the PLC only. Entire heart of our industrial automation is nothing but our PLC only. So every signal will go to the PLC coming from the PLC. Okay. And SCADA we are going to use in a remote area, and HMI we are going to use in a local area. And memory is less, memory is high, and screen designing is limited, it is an unlimited. Designing is also high here, SCADA. Designing is less here in the HMI. Okay, in this diagram, you will get industrial automation exactly what these models are going to use, like HMI, PLC, and SCADA. Okay, if you have any doubts and clarification, please put in the comment box so that I can give the report. Okay. In the next, what we are going to learn in the SCADA is nothing but you need to learn your training should as the screens design. Okay. Like how you are going to monitor with the PLC and how you are going to control with the PLC. Everything we can. Okay. Next. Next, VFD. Variable frequency drive. Generally, every working people will know about this one already, VFD. It is used for a general application like speed and direction. Okay. Generally, VFD is useful for speed and direction control. But for speed and direction control, we have alternate option is also there. Then why we need an VFD? That is, for example, for speed controlling, resistance tabbing will be there. Till then, some old of our client is still they are going to use some resistance tabbing. We replaced with our technology. Okay, and coming to the direction also. For direction controlling, we have RDL status will be there. Reverse direct online status will be there. Okay, behind of these advantages, behind of this is all advantages, there is a VFD advantage is also there. What that advantage is nothing but let us say, for example, in speed also you can take an fixed and variable. That is one thing. And the next is going to reduce in the starting current. Okay, it is going to reduce in the starting current. How it is going to reduce in the starting current is nothing but inside of an DFD, we have a circuit arranged, a resistance band that we're going to call a smoothing circuit. Okay, through the smoothing circuit, you can reduce your starting current of a particular motor. When current is reduced, then automatically power consumption will also reduce. When power consumption is also reducing, then automatically certain losses will reduce. When losses is reducing, then automatically motor efficiency is going to increase. And one more advantage is there, that is short circuit protection. And the next, harmonic detection. Harmonic detection. Okay, it is going to be, and circuitry will be there for protecting this one also. For short circuit protection, harmonic protection, we have an inside circuitry will be there in the BFD. Okay, then what is the difference between this PLC and BFD? All people are thinking that without a PLC, there is no use of a BFD. No, don't think like that. Okay, depends upon the need of a particular application. It is going to change all. That means you can run your motor with PLC, and without PLC also you can run your application. How it is going to follow? Let us say, for example, client is asking only and direction or on off is enough to me easily, but there is no need to control with the PLC. Okay, let's say for example, an on button is enough to run the vehicles, an off button is enough to stop the vehicle. If the client is asking only on off, then you can go with the only vehicle. Okay, and one more thing, let us say for example, sir, I need one speed controlling is enough, like variable less like that. That means I need to vary the speed of a particular motor. I need to use one potentiometer. Through potentiometer, I need to vary the speeds. That type of requirement is also there to the client. That type of situation also you can use only with VFD. Then where, in which situation we are going to use with PLC? Without PLC also we can run. In the only running condition is enough to be like that conditions. But without PLC, we can run okay. With PLC, where we need one with PLC is nothing but, let us say for example, some special conditions. Let us say for example, I have a tank in the motor. Okay, I have a tank here. In tank, to fill the water or something, chemical or whatever it is, to fill this one, I'm going to use one pumping motor. Pumping motor system. It is going to interlink with this tank. What is the condition is nothing but when tank is in low level, then pump motor should stop. When it reaches to high level, then automatically pump motor should off. Here there is a conditions will be there. Okay, low and middle, low level and high level sensors will be there. No? Everything first, the signals will come to the PLC. Everything will come to the PLC. PLC is going to operate the BFD. If it is in low level, then automatically it will give some signal to the BFD here. Okay. Let's say, for example, a tag is in low level. You need to run your pump holder system. I mean, it reaches to high level. Okay. BFD should stop the pumping. Okay, that is one condition. Let us say, for example, some more conditions will be there. Like conveyor applications will be there. No? In conveyor also say, let us say, for example, in conveyor, bottles is going. Okay, when this bottle count reaches to 1 lakh or something over, 1 lakh or something, it reaches to 1 lakh automatically, this conveyor should off. Conveyor is interlinked with the PFD. Okay, what tweezer is going to running here and then, but the sensors will on off now. Sensors on off count will come to the PLC. PLC, when it reaches to 1 lakh, then automatically it will give signal to the PFD to stop your conveyor. Because conveyor is interlinked with the BFD. Okay, this is with PLC and without PLC also. What you are going to learn in our institute is nothing but you are going to learn here VFD connections. Before VFD connections, and all starting techniques of motor starting, like reverse starter, RDS starter, and star delta starter wiring, power and control wiring. Then next VFD. VFD also with PLC, without PLC, how you are going to give the wiring and parameterization of the VFD here instead of the parameter. How we need to enter the VFD parameters through keypad and external devices, through external, how you're going to run each and everything can learn from our institute. These are the four modules. Okay. If you have anyone have interested, just put your name and number in the chat box in the comment section. And please subscribe our channel for more updates. And the next, click on bell icon on. Click on bell icon for getting notifications of our training institute videos. And the next, please share with your friends for getting the technical updates. Okay. And the next, please give a comment also for your feedback on this demo sessions. Okay. Thank you.